Morning students, how are you all? Hope you are good. Today we are going to discuss about remaining our relations. So here first one, symmetric relation. In this symmetric relation, ordered pairs are interchangeable. Means if ordered pair A comma B belongs to R, then it superimposes B comma A is also belongs to R, for every A comma B is belongs to R. Here identity and universal relations are always symmetric. What is universal relation? If A cross A is a subset of A cross A, then A cross A is a subset of also A cross A. It superimposes, both relations are superimposes. Here converse is possible. And next one, from identity relation, A is related to itself. This type of relation is called as identity relation. The relation is 1 to 1, ordered pairs are 1 to 1, 2 comma 2 and 3 comma 3. When we have to interchange these first ordered pair, then result is also gives us 1 comma 1 and interchanging 2 comma 2, interchanging 3 comma 3. This relation is also equals to the our first relation. This type of relation is called symmetric relation. Here one of the example, A is equals to set of all lines in a plane. So relation A comma B, such that A is perpendicular to B, then A comma B belongs to A. So when A is perpendicular to B, B is also perpendicular to A. This type of relation is called symmetric relation. This is our next relation, transitive relation. In this relation, if A comma B, set of ordered pairs are belongs to relation R, and B comma C also belongs to R, then that imposes A comma C is belongs to also R. This type of relation is called transitive. For every elements A comma B comma C belongs to A. This is the arrow diagram of given data. If A is belongs to B and B is belongs to C, then A is also belongs to C. This type of relation we can call as transitive relation. So identity and universal relations are the transitive relation. Here set A is equals to elements A comma B comma C. Identity relation is A comma A and B comma B and C comma C. And universal relation A cross A is equals to all possible relations from A to A. A comma A, B comma B, C comma C. A B, A C, B A, B C, C A, C B. Here if A to B and B to C is possible, then A belongs to C. This type of relation we can call as transitive relation. So examples, divisible by, greater than, less than, parallel to, congruent to, this type of all types of relations are the examples of transitive relations. So first we have to take some elements 2 comma 4 comma 6. Here 4 is divisible by 2, 6 is also divisible by 4. It imposes the 6 is also divisible by 2. This type of relation we can call as transitive. And next one, greater than or less than examples. 2 comma 4 comma 6. Here 4 is greater than 2 and 6 is greater than 4. Then 6 is also greater than 2. This type of relation is also called as transitive. Next one, parallel to. If A is parallel to B, B is parallel to C, then A is also parallel to C. This type of relation is one of the example of transitive. So congruent triangles, all congruent triangles in a plane. Here this triangle is congruent to this one and this one is congruent to this one. So both are congruent to each other. This is the one of the example of transitive relation. So next one, anti-symmetric relation. If A comma B is belongs to R and B comma A does not belongs to R, is called anti-symmetric relation. Or A comma B is belongs to R and B comma A is belongs to R unless A is equals to B. So example, multiple of, here 2 is multiple of 4 and 4 is not a multiple of 2. These type of relation are called anti-symmetric relations. This is our next relation, equivalence relation. If a relation R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, then the type of relation we can call as equivalence relation. Example, the relation is parallel to, here the relation is parallel to on a set of all lines in a plane. So this type of relation is the reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Then we can call it as this type of relation is an equivalence relation. Next one, the R is a relation is similar to on the set of all triangles in a plane. This is also an example of equivalence relation. Is similar to the set of all triangles in a plane. This is your homework. So if A comma B, first question, are two non-empty sets containing entirely different elements, then A cross B intersection B cross A is equals to. Next one, if ordered pairs x plus 4 comma 6 is equals to 2 comma y plus 3, equals to means first ordered pair is equals to first order pair and second one is equals to second one, then x is equal to dash and y is equals to dash. Third one, if a is equals to 1 comma 2 and b is equals to x comma y, then a cross b, all possible relations from a to b, a cross b means is equals to dash. Fourth one, given that a comma b and c are three non-empty sets, so a cross b is equals to a cross c, then what is the relation of ABC? If R is an identity relation on 2, 5, 6, then number of ordered pairs in relation R is equals to number of ordered pairs. What is the relation? Identity relation, IA. Sixth one, write the different types of relations from set A to A. Here A is equals to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4. How many relations are there? Universal relation, identity relation, reflexive relation, symmetric relation, transitive relation and anti-symmetric relation and equivalence relation. These are the all different types of relations. You should write all possible relations from A to A, including ordered pairs. Okay students, if you have any doubts, please contact my number. Thank you.